sign. So that's how I prove this question. Okay, so let me start. Before we start, let me refresh our previous knowledge and think about the tangent square x or tangent square x. Okay, so is there any relation that we can use? So that's the tips how to start to learn the question. Okay, sometimes we have to convert or change the trigonometric function to the other similar. So that's after that we will have to see the connection or the relation to get the right hand side equation. Okay, so now I know that tangent square x actually we can say that equal to sine square x over cos square x. Okay, for cotangent square x, it is actually we can say that it is equal to also 1 over tangent square x. And at the same time, your tangent square x here is equal with the sine square x over cos square x. So we got the 1 over this fraction sine square x over cos square x. So let's change into the cos square x over sine square x. Okay, so this is the thing that I will use to open this question. Okay, so you can see that now. From left hand side, for tangent square x, I change into sine square x over cos square x. Okay, the yellow one here. For the cotangent square x, I change into cos square x over sine square x here, the color one here. Okay, if I can see this is in your working step, okay, you got the 1 marks here. Okay, this is the question. Because you change from this tangent square x to cotangent square x. Okay, next. What happened? Okay, I solved this equation and I solved this question. So, teacher selesaikan persamaan ni. So, macam mana kita nak selesaikan persamaan fraction ni? As usual lah, macam you dah belajar sendiri. Kan kalau kita nak mudahkan sesuatu fraction, contoh lah teacher guna. Okay, example, if I have x over 3 minus y over 4. So how can I solve this fraction? The first one here, okay, the 3 and 4 here, we multiply, correct? Okay, 3 times 4. Okay, and for this one x, I multiply with 4. And for the other side here, minus y, I multiply with 3. Okay, I think everyone know, okay? So this is the rule how we do the multiply. Sorry, we do the operation addition or subtraction for any fraction. Okay, so this is the same concept, the same step for this one also. But now we have our denominator is cos square x and sine square x. That's why you have to multiply here. Okay, the sine square x here, and we multiply also the cos square x here. Clear? How I get this one? Okay, let's make this one first. Okay, and then okay, next I multiply the sine square x with sine square x. So what will be the answer? It becomes sine to the power of 4x. Okay? And cos square x multiply cos square x, I got cos power of 4x. Okay? And yang bawah tu denominator dia tu tak use ya. Just buat je cos square x multiply sin square x. Okay, next. I factorize this sin power of 4x minus cos power of 4x. Become the sin square x minus cos square x. Sin square x plus cos square x. Okay, yang ini ni kalau you all ingat balik, you all dah belajar sebelum. So this one is a square minus b square. Okay, so what will happen here? So this is a minus b square, and then we can simplify as a minus b multiply a plus b. one is power of 4. Kita ada sekarang ni power of 4 kan. So ini kita ada kuasa 4. Bermaksud kita keluarkan kuasa 2 ni kat dalam, masih lagi ada kuasa 2 lah. That's why dalam ni semua lagi ada kuasa 2. Kuasa 2, kuasa 2. Okay, so this is I explain how I get to this equation here. Okay, cuman macam nampak equation ni. Okay, and then for your information, for double formula, double angle formula, you know that sin square x plus cos square x is equals to 1. Okay, so use this one into here to change to become 1 here. Again, for the plus operation here. Now, we have sin square x minus cos square x multiply 1. And divide by cos square x multiply sin square x. So for this one, what happened now? Okay, I separate sin square x over this cos square x. Sin square x minus with cos square x over cos square x multiply sin square x. Okay, macam mana kita dapat yang ini? Okay, example here. Okay, kita ada x tolak y untuk dengan 4 tu kan. It is actually similar and equal with x over 4 minus y. Kita boleh je buat macam tu. Okay, kenapa? Sebab kita nak memudahkan, kita nak asingkan satu-satu ni kerana kita nak simplify. Okay, kalau you all boleh perhatikan masuk ke kelas ni. Okay, kenapa kita buat macam tu? Sebab nampak tak? Kita ada sin square x, sin square x ya. So, I can simplify this one because now it is one term. So this is operation multiplication. So when I simplify this one, I got 1 over cos square x. And it is actually equal to second square x. Okay class? Okay, and this one, I can simplify cos square x. So I get 1 over sin square x. So this is also equal to cosec square x. And now, it is actually equal to the right hand side now. So this I. Okay, so how I give the marks, okay, the first one here, I show you already, I tell you already this one, I told you already this one for 1 mark, and I can see that, okay, you have this equation, okay, or this equation, I know lah yang mana kesesuaian ni 1 mark, and then you prove, okay, with the other side 1 mark, so you got 3 mark for this proven question, okay, so, I hope with my explanation, okay, you can answer the similar question